personal goodness and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope. Now.
I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends, if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We pray for all who have died or suffer as a result of conflict, those whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, for servicemen and women, for civilians, for those held captive, each one remembered by and known to God. May God give peace. God give peace. We pray for peacemakers and peacekeepers, those who seek to keep this world secure and free, for all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. May God give peace. God, give peace. Finally, we pray for all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. May God give peace. God, give peace. Trusting in the compassion of God, let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen. such innocence. Never before or since has changed itself to past without a word. The men leaving the gardens tidy, thousands of marriages lasting a little while longer. Never such innocence again.
As we prepare to leave this place, let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace? We will. Will you seek to heal the wounds of war? We will. Will you work for a just future for all humanity? We will. Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you all and remain with you always. Amen. Go forth with hope and seek for peace in the service of God. In the name of Christ. Amen.